Hello friends, so today in this video we are going to talk about elliptical trammels, or it is a part of double slider crank mechanism. Double slider crank chain mechanism, okay. So in this video I'll cover its animation as well as its theory, okay, both I'll cover. So in elliptical trammel, what are these and why we use them? Okay, so first of all we will talk about what is double slider crank mechanism. So double slider crank mechanism consists of two turning pairs, okay, and there are two sliding pairs. In the previous video of single slider crank mechanism, I have talked about there were only one sliding pair and three turning pairs, and in this one there is two turning pair and two sliding pairs. So elliptical trammel is one of the inversion of double slider crank mechanism. So I have already discussed about inversion of mechanism. So it is the inversion of double slider. So what is an elliptical trammel? Thus we can call it as a device. It is a device which is used to draw ellipse. Okay, from the word elliptical we can understand that it says that it will form ellipse. Okay, so it is used for drawing ellipses. Or if we will do some considerations, then we can convert it for drawing circles as well. So in the end of the video we will discuss how we could draw circles from this as well. Okay, so first of all let's draw see its animation, and then we'll draw its diagram. Okay, so this is the animation of elliptical trammel, and in this we can see that how it rotates inside this groove cut and groove areas, and it is forming a ellipse. You can see the slider is moving inside this case or throttle plate. Now let us draw its diagram. Okay, so it consists of two sliding pairs and two turning pairs. So this seems to be something like this. Okay, here one sliding pair, one, and this one is another one. Okay, both of them are connected to each other. Suppose this is some point P, okay, and this is A, this is B. Now this is there are two sliders, and this is the section in which it slides, and this section is called a slotted plate. Okay, slotted plate. This comprises a single link. Say it is link 4. This is the fixed link. Okay, and these are the sliders. Sliders, they are link 1 and 3. This one is link 1. This one is link 3. So what happens in it when it goes down? Then it moves forward, backward, and due to that, this will trace a path. Okay, so it will trace path something like this, and when it moves forward, then it will move like this, and it will go downward. When it comes back, then it will start rising like this, and it will form an ellipse. Okay, here we can see that AP and PB forms a semi major axis and semi minor axis of for this ellipse. Okay, so let's see this. AP semi major axis, and PB semi minor axis. you can easily understand this PB is acting as a semi major axis for this. Okay, this would be maximum this much, and this would be a semi major axis for the ellipse. Okay, now move on. Let us draw its another diagram for this, or free body diagram for this. Okay, so it would be something like this. This is the x axis and this is y. This one is x and this is the y. And suppose this is the point A on which this line, this is point A. Okay, and this one is point B of slider 1, A and B. This is some point P in between. Okay, now it will form some angle theta with the x-axis. Okay, so if we'll extend this line or draw its projection down here, then it would be say x and this one would be y. So this height would be y. So we can recapitulate that cos theta would be x upon base upon hypotenuse. Okay, so it would be this would not be y, because this is not the height for the ellipse. It would be a y. Okay, so this is y. Now we'll consider cos theta. This would also be theta. Okay, and this would also be x. So cos theta would be base upon hypotenuse, so this p and some point over here, o. So x upon hypotenuse, so this would be x upon ap. So x would be equal to ap cos theta. Okay, and what would be y? So y would be pb sin theta. Okay, pb sin theta. So sin theta would be equal to y upon pb. So we have two equations, 1 and 2, squaring both equation and adding them. So cos square theta plus sin square theta equal to x upon ap square plus y upon pb square. So this would be equal to 1, and the ap square plus y upon pb square, and this forms some standard equation, and this equation is of ellipse. Okay, sorry. But in this AP is the semi major axis and PB is the semi minor axis. Consider that AP is equal to PB, or say P is midpoint. Okay, then what would happen in this case? This would be the same, so it would be AP square equal to x square plus y square, and this would be formed. This would be the equation of circle, standard equation of circle, whose radius is AP. And by doing that, we could draw a circle using this elliptical trammel method. So this is it. Thank you for watching. If you find this video helpful, then please give a thumbs up. Please do like, share and comment. Thank you for watching.